Today, we're going to learn all about footnotes and references within Adobe Acrobat. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. References and footnotes can be a little tricky to implement as there is not clear guidance from the WCAG standards on how to format these within Adobe Acrobat. This is the method that I like to use. I have a two-page document that has some endnotes at the bottom and a couple of references throughout the content. Let's go ahead and find this first number one here. In Adobe Acrobat, instead of this being a span tag, as span tags don't have any real value, they are simply a visual tag, we want to instead make this a reference tag. So to do that, I'm going to right-click the tag, select Properties, and we're going to change it to a reference, and then select Close. Additionally, this is not a requirement, but oftentimes you will see the number is actually hyperlinked to the endnote that it's referring to. So I'm going to right-click the number one and select Create Link, and I want to, under Link Action, select Go to Page View and select Next. Then I'm going to scroll down to my endnotes and select set link. This then creates a hyperlink that I can click on, and it will take me directly to that spot in the document. Now, the next thing I want to do is apply some alternate text. This is where there are differences in opinion. So I'm first going to show you one method, and then we'll go over another method. The first method is to simply provide guidance on where this end note or reference is leading to. So we can do that by applying alternate text. I'm going to select the reference tag, select properties, and in the alternate text, I'm going to provide the following. Superscript 1 refers to end note 1 on page 2, and we can select close. So that is one method that will alert the screen reader user of what this reference or endnote is referring to. So that's sort of option one. Here's another method. Note is read directly after the reference. So I am moving my L-body content, the actual content of the endnote, under the reference tag. And let's make this a note tag. And so in the reading order, this P tag is going to go from the first part of the paragraph, read the reference, and then read the note, and then go back to the main content. So this is the second method for tagging your references and notes within a document. Let's go over the third method. Another option that we can do is actually provide the notes here in the alternate text. So let's just take, I'm going to copy the contents to the clipboard for this first note, and let's go back to our reference, right click, select properties, and this is where we would actually put the alternate text or the actual text for this field. So let's do it on the actual text so I know for sure that it's being read. We would say superscript 1, period, and then paste what the superscript actually is and select close. We would then go down into the endnote, right click, and change that content to an artifact and then delete out the tags. So that's the third method where we are applying the actual note onto the actual text of the reference and then artifacting the actual endnote. So as you can see, there are multiple methods to tag a reference and a footnote or endnote. One final thing here, I forgot to actually put all of this content into a note. So I'm going to right click, select new tag and create a note and drag my list elements into that section. Now, there most likely will come a time where there's additional guidance on specifically how to tag this content. Throughout my career, I have tagged PDF documents the way that you saw, in this video. There's three different methods. Depending on who you're working with, they may want it tagged a different way. But at this time, the methods I have shown are the most effective for tagging references within an Adobe Acrobat file. As always, thank you for watching. And remember, I can be your personal accessibility expert, and I hope to see you next time.